the Shiv Yoga says, and the Vedic philosophy, it says, that you have five bodies. You don't have only physical body, but you have five bodies. As I said yesterday, when I met in my younger age a great yogi, he taught me the subtle bodies, the sukshma shariras. And from him I learned that the etheric body, the prana sharira, which you cannot even feel it physically, but that is more powerful than your physical body. In fact, we had done some experiments in Rishikesh Shivir long back, where I had taught them how Lord Bajrangbali, Anjaneya Swami, how he could lift the mountain. It is very much possible, the moment you enter in the etheric body, you can lift any weight without any problem. And that is what I had demonstrated. And all the sadhaks there, they could easily lift 100 kg or 200 kg weight with their two fingers. You know, that I had demonstrated. And not only that, once you enter into higher body, it is very easy for you to bend a iron rod or any heavy metal very easily. So that is the power which you have. The people, they do karate, you know, karate, they have to focus and they have to strengthen this thing. So there I had asked for wooden blocks, and that wood was a wet wood, which is very hard to break. And when the sadhaks, they entered into their etheric body, and they were just hitting the wooden block and it was breaking. You know, there were more than 1,000, and more than 1,000 blocks we had broken at that time. So what I'm saying is, that is only the physical strength, but there is a lot more is there. That is the fourth dimension. Fourth dimension means your etheric body can be present here, and if you project, it can be present anywhere. The phenomena or the limitations of third dimensions are not applicable to your next body, that is the etheric body. So the time, distance, space, that is not. You can expand your body as much as you can, and you can shrink your body as much as you can.